stay wrong in love. So many signs, so little time. Down shines the moon, and the shadows grow. Crashing to earth, some reach to the sky. Down shines the moon, and the shadows grow as the night fades away. The dreamer's fantasies come true. I've got an eye on you, but I know you're looking too. And our chances only roll the dice. Roll the dice.
That sounds a bit Swedish to me, is it?
Yes, it is. My father, my father was born in Sweden. He grew up in America, though. He moved when he was 2 or 3 years old. And, my both grandparents were born and raised in Sweden. I think it was Värmland that they grew up. And so I got the same name as my father. It's an old country Swedish name.
You didn't start out as a guitarist, but as a classical trained accordionist.
I was born in Chicago, and I guess when I was 5 or 6 years old, at least in Chicago, that was the instrument everybody played, was the accordion. So I started taking lessons. I really wanted to, of course. And I moved to Washington, D.C. when I was about 9 or 10, but I continued studying accordion for about 10 years. And after a couple years of that, I started writing my own songs. And very quickly, growing up, I realized, well, I'd rather do my own music than imitate people. But that's how everybody learns, really, is you start copying the people that you love. And if you are going to get a style of your own, you have to start somewhere. And of course, you start with the music that's dearest to you. And that's how I started. And of course, once I got in Grimm, I was starting to write my own music. So from then on, I started doing originals.
You once said in an interview that you want to write about things that are really happening, not what you read in papers. Could you comment on that?
I don't like to write about things I don't know about, you know. I don't want to write a song against nuclear energy or write a protest song about a war because I don't know that much about it, you know. And I've never been in a war myself. And I think it's kind of ludicrous for me to start telling governments or people how to live or act or what's wrong with their lives. I'd rather write about things I know about, which are simple things.
One of your sort of live specialities is somersaulting on the trampoline.
Yeah, I only do it once at the end of the night, and sometimes I jump up on the trampoline just to bounce around a little bit, and it gives me a chance to look at the band and the audience because it's on the side of the stage. Because when I sing, my back's to the band, and when I turn around to play with the band, my back's to the audience, and sometimes I get confused and I don't want to ignore either one. So the trampoline is just something I thought people might give them something to look at the end of the night. I put my guitar down and go throw a backflip. Not all the time, but I'll do it tonight.
on the album you play with the greatest session men in the States. Wouldn't it be tempting to get these on the road?
Of course it would, but they make so much money that you would have to be Elton John or Paul McCartney to be able to take them away from their homes, Los Angeles and New York. They work day in, day in, day in, night and make incredible sums of money, and rightfully so, they're excellent players. But to take them on tour, like I say, you'd have to be a multimillionaire, and that's a problem I don't have.
Talk to me, what is wrong? I walk the door while you're out all night long. I am feeling lonesome and sad. I am missing what we had. And I won't have an empty heart. No, I can't stand living with an empty heart. Window pane, I saw you kissing him in the rain. In the mirror I see the broken man. He said it's over and it's time we ran. 'Cause I won't have an empty heart. No, I can't stand living with an empty heart. Crossed. You said I needed you to stay alive. I had to walk away too soon.